In 1025 AD, Rajendra Chola, King Chola of Tamil Nadu in South India, launched a naval attack against the port of Srivijaya in Southeast Asia. The Chola invasion led to the collapse of the Srivijaya dynasty, and the Chola invasion also coincided with the return journey of the great Buddhist scholar Atisa from Sumatra to India and Tibet in 1025. In the Muotakui site area in the area of the old temple, there is a mound of earth. This is not a cremation area. But this is the place where the Chola savages slaughtered 17 envoys of the Datchuak to make peace and only heaped them with dirt, on the background of an old temple with a red brick floor. These Chola savages, the local people, call them Anjik Garang, who wanted to seize and control the holy city of the Srivijaya chamber. Holy city. Before 78 AD named Mong Takui. Until now, the local people called Muo Takui. After the Dutch era until now, it was published as Muera Takas Temple. Here the remaining traces of Kadachuan before and after were called Sriwijaya. Complete with the oldest university and the Bodhi tree, a witness and evidence to reveal the true history of Indonesia. The Chola invasion attacked the Sriwijaya Sailendra dynasty, because they were also their predecessors, already knowing that from this land their ancestors learned the teachings of Dharmic original. The Purana and Mahavamsa state that Ashoka's father was Emperor Maurya Bindusara and his grandfather was Chandragupta, the founder of the empire. Ashokavadana states that Ashoka's mother is the daughter of a Brahmin from Champa and is prophesied to marry a king. Her father took her to Pataliputra, where she was inducted into Bindusara's harem and eventually became its chief queen. Vamsathapakasini or Mahavamsa Tika, a discussion of the Mahavamsa, calls him Dharma. Dhamma, in Pali, states that he is from the Maurya Kshatriya clan. A Divyavadana legend calls himself Janapada Kalyani. Aya Ashoka, Bindusara, ruled for 25 years, not 28 years as Sri Lanka records. If this is true of Ashoka's ascension 3 years earlier to 268 BC, and we assume that Buddha died in 486 BC, then Ashoka's time would be 268 BC. Magaliputta Tissa, protected by Ashoka, sent 9 missions. Each mission consisted of 5 monks and was led by an elder. He sent his own son Mahinda, accompanied by 4 other Theras, Ithya, Uddiya, Sambala and Badasala. Furthermore, with the help of Magaliputta Tissa, Ashoka sent to distant regions such as Kashmir, Gandhara, Himalayas, the land of Yonas, Greece, Maharashtra, Suvarnabhumi, Svarnadvipa, Nusantara, Indonesia. In the 18th year of Ashoka's reign, mentioning the names of those who went on pilgrimage also carried the following missions. Mahinda to Sri Lanka. Majantika to Kashmir and Gandhara. Mahadeva to Mahisa Mandala. Rakita to Vanavasa, to Uparantaka, West India. Maha Dhamma Rakita to Maharashtra, Maharakita to Greece. Majima to the Himalayas. Sona and Uttara to Suvabhumi, Svarnadvipa, Nusantara, Indonesia. During the year of the 19th reign, Ashoka's daughter, Sanghamitta, went to Sri Lanka to form an order of nuns, taking the saplings of the sacred Bodhi tree with her. The former center for Maju Nusantara civilization, a place to teach and learn the teachings of the archipelago's ancestral, Dharmic original. Before being named Srivijaya, there was a holy city named Montakui. The local people previously called Muotakui. After the Dutch era until now, it was published as Muera Takas Temple, complete with the university and the traces of the Bodhi tree. The people named it the Ashoka tree. The Bodhi tree has its Latin name Ficus religiosa. The species known as Bodhi tree, Pipula tree, Peepal tree or Ashwata tree, a fig species native to the Indian subcontinent, southwest China and Indochina, it belongs to the Moraceae family of fig and mulberry. In the highest area around the Puja center, there are still traces of an Ashoka Bodhi tree, which was brought by King Ashoka to the archipelago when he was doing Samadhi in the place of the Dharmic masters, Brahmins, Bhattara Guru, RSHI, Datchuak doing Tapo, Batharic, Upasena, Kamala contemplation, finished the end of his study. This was also done by the first King Ashoka and Atisa Dipamkara Shrenyana from Tibet. It is also mandatory for the Datchuak in the Srivijaya chamber. This king of Ashoka brought Ashoka tree seeds from his country, did Samadhi until the seeds took root and grew. The estimated time was 10 to 20 days. In this place also among the students from Tibet learn and do it. Atisa Dipamkara Shrenyana, year 1013 AD, he traveled to Srivijaya, stayed for 12 years to study, then returned to India, died 1054 year in Nitang, Tibet. Atisa Dipankara Sreñana offered many jewels and gold. His followers also offered one gold coin for each of his students Guru Dharmakirti Suvarnadvipa. Guru Dharmakirti Suvarnadvipa dedicated Budarapang to Dipankara and he stayed at the Silver Umbrella Palace in Suvarnadvipa for 12 years. While here he slept on the floor, at the foot of his teacher's bed as a sign of respect for the student to the teacher. This is evidence of historical facts about Bodhi tree, as well as about Atisa Dipankara at the Silver Umbrella Palace, while studying with Svarnadvipa Dharmakirti at the former Dharmic Original Learning Center at the Srivijaya Kadachuan Center, Indonesia. The Tamil inscription of Rajendra Chola I, the one who sent many ships in the middle of the turbulent sea and captured the Rama Wijayatunga Warman, the king of Kadaram, along with the elephants in his victorious army, seized a large pile of treasures, which the king had legally accumulated. Seized with a sound, a bow is called Vidyadharadharana at the war gate of his vast city, Srivijaya, with a small-eyed gate, adorned with great splendor and a gate of great gems. Panai with water in the bath ghat, ancient Malayur with sturdy mountains as fortresses, Mayuridingam, surrounded by the deep sea as a defensive moat, the Langasoka, i.e. Langasoka, was undaunted in intense combat. Mapapalam had abundant, deep waters for defense, Mevalimbangam had sharp walls as defense, Valapindaru has Valapindaru. Talaidakulam was praised by the great people, good at science, Madamalingam, tough in big and fierce battles, Ilamaridisam, whose mighty power arose in war, Manakavaram, who in his wide flower garden honey is gathered, and the Kadaram, which has tremendous power, which is protected by the deep sea. Mainanga is located in the upper reaches of the Kampar River, where the Kampar Kanan and Kampar Kiri rivers meet. Chinese pilgrims call this Kampar River, Panai, or Punai. In the historical period 900 to 300 years ago, the southeastern coast of Sumatra consisted of a series of large bays, Bunka and Blitung Islands were still one peninsula with Riau Lingga Malacca, the coastline of Sumatra Island, especially in the southern part, was far away, the area which is now inland. The east coast of the island of Sumatra is somewhat looking inland, in the Jambi area there is a deep bay with three islands at the mouth of the bay. The city of Jambi was formerly located on the seashore to the south of the large bay. In the Palembang area there was a peninsula that shone into the sea, and the city of Palembang with Bukit Siguntang is located at the end of the peninsula. Due to this situation, the central location of the Srivijaya Kadachuan was strategic, that is, ships sailing from China to India always stopped by, or vice versa, the ships had to sail south around Blitung Island while stopping at the center of the Srivijaya Kadachuan. News of its existence was obtained from the book Tang Wei Yao compiled by Wang Pu in 961 during the Tang Dynasty, where Mainanga sent an envoy to China in 645. Mainanga was the center of the Malay Kingdom. Apart from the news book Tang Wei Yao, from the Zefu Yuan Kui book of the Song Dynasty which was made on the basis of old history by Wang Chaan Zhou and Yang I between 1005 and 1013, also tells of an envoy from the Malay Kingdom came to China between 644 and 645. During the Yuan Dynasty and Ming Dynasty with different spellings due to changes in each dynasty mentioned in Chinese history to refer to a nation from the southern sea said Ma Liu, Bak Liu, Mak Liu, Ma Liu Ur, Ulai Yu, Wulai Yu. Chinese records also mention a number of other kingdoms that are also related to trade in the Malacca Strait. Pol, Ko Ying, Kantuli, Pulei, Poota, Pohuang, Puanpuan, Tantan and Holotan are some of the early kingdoms thought to have emerged in the archipelago, especially Java and Sumatra. Ko Ying is an early kingdom that emerged around the 3rd century AD which was later replaced by Holotan in West Java before the appearance of Kantuli 441-563, ad which mentioned by O.W. Wolters as the most important trading empire. Atisa Dipankara Sreñana, 321-393 AD, according to Taranatha, Atisa Dipankara Sreñana was a contemporary of King Bayapala and Nayapala, 360-400 AD. He became the head of the Odantapuri and Vikramasila monasteries. He learned about original Dharmic in Suvarnadvipa, lived 12 years in Sumatra, he was a key figure in the founding of Tibetan Buddhism. The Chinese pilgrim Yi Xing, L.T. Xing, 635-713, left his country for Kin Chio, Kinti Golden Land, Svarnadvipa, Indonesia formerly called Srivijaya, Fo Che, or Che Li Fo Che, for study, at the Dharmic learning center called Dharma Phala, branching out in Bihar, India, Nalanda. The village where Sariputra was born from a mother named Sari or Sarika Rupasari, in the Fahian version of Bimbisara is Pian Po So Lo in Nalaka village, in the Motu Lo area. This is Malacca, in Malayu. Fahian 337-422 ad lived in Chang'an. Starting from 399-412 ad departing from Chang'an, crossing Lung. After crossing the Indus, the distance across the southern Indian Sea is 4 to 5 million li, until anchored on a flat land without a valley, there is a river. Going to the southeast less than 80 yojana, we passed many temples with a number of priests in them. After passing this place, we arrived which was called Motu Lo. Following the river, Puna, right and left there are 20 Sangharamas with 3,000 priests. The climate here is warm evenly without snow, the people are very rich, there are no taxes or official restrictions. All over the land people don't kill poultry, doves don't drink wine, they don't eat garlic, don't raise pigs, don't drink wine. The chiefs build Sangharama for priests. Go west to arrive at the village, Na Lo, this is the birthplace of Sariputra, therefore a tower has been erected. Upatissa village, known as Nalaka, lived a very intelligent young man named Sariputra. His mother was Sarika Rupasari. Because of her mother's name he was called Sariputra. His father was Mathara, a Brahmin surnamed Durganika. Because he was the son of the village leader, he was also sometimes called Upatissa. In the place of the priests, there was a Sangharama built. Here they made a tower to honor Sariputra, Mudgalaputra, also to honor Abhidharma, Vinaya and Sutra. From east to west 5 or 6 li, from north to south 7 or 8 li, here Sariputra and Mudgalyayana first met Isbahit as well as Nirgrantha. From the south of the city continuing south 4 li, we entered a valley situated between 5 hills, encircling completely like a wall. This is the site of the old city of King, Pian Po So Lo. Svarnadvipa, Indonesia, not India, is the starting point of learning resources for the principles of Dharma, Dhamma. And this is the figure of the previous Indonesian men in the BC era, the pioneers of Dharmic, to the land of India. Dharmadasa 700-620 BC, Dharmapala 670-580 BC, Suvarnadvipa Dharmakirti 610 BC 520 BC, Kumarila Bhattai 618-540 BC, Adi Sankara 569-537 BC. They, Paratharan, Putra Nusantara, Dharmic, pioneers from this land Svarnadvipa, Sumatra Indonesia as the embryo of Buddhism, originated here. Original Dharmic, learning center. In the period before, Suvarnadvipi Dharmakirti. A Brahmin named Kin F.A. Suvarnaksa, he was born into a Brahmin family at the age of 17 he mastered all to the scientist, Veda. Suvarnaksa one of the six great non-Buddhist masters he died before Shakyamuni the Buddha entered, Nirvana. Suvarnaksa from Suvarnadvipa Kin Chio came to Rajagra and met Upatissa or Sariputra. Shakyamuni the Buddha Gautama summoned the venerable Sariputra and asked him to ordain Rahula, his son who became known as the first novice in the world. Samanera means future monk. Sariputra comes from a Brahmin family and already started a spiritual life when he met the teachings of the Buddha. Sariputra's friend, Mahamoggallana, an ascetic, they both renounced and became a disciple of the skeptic Sanjaya. Sanjaya of Suvarnadvipa was a contemporary teacher with Mahavira, the figure, Jainism, and the Buddha, a supporter of the skeptical Ajnana school of thought. The knowledge, Jainyana, of all beings will not be equal in comparison to the wisdom, Prajna, and learning, Bahusrita, of the disciple Sanjaya's Sariputra. Of all the Buddha's disciples, the Sariputra is by far the foremost in the Prajna, wisdom. Prajnaparamita is about understanding the Bodhisattva Mahasattvas, Dharmic, Dharma, teaching philosophy, the Buddha mentioned here for the Sariputra. The philosophy of Dharmic, or Dharma teachings, European philosophers called this the essence that underlies the teachings of Eastern religions, Jainism, Hinduism, Buddhism, Sikh and Zoroaster. Kri Janayasa Dapuntha Hyang, 6th century 4th year 11th day did, Siddhayatra, holy journey carrying, Dharma, from Dharma Phala, University in Svarnadvipa. This location is in view of Fa Huan in the 4th century AD and Ithising in the 7th century AD. went out to the north as well as to the west with 2,213 students, Brahmins. This is what Rshi Markandeya did to Bali. This is where, Dharmak, is perfectly stored. The Kodakapur inscription is one of the five stone curse inscriptions made by Dapyunta Hyang, a ruler of Kadachuan Sriwijaya. Dharma teachings, recorded in word literacy. Kusala Dharmabhajana. Inscribed on the bas-relief of Vana Chaka Phala. Now published named Borobudur. The language and philosophy of its teachings are native to the teachings of the Archipelago Nusantara Indonesia before, not one of the two teachings that were born in India. But underlies the growth of the three teachings that were born there. Jainism, Hinduism, Buddhism. By Santosaba.